They don't know that yet. Because, you see, no matter how alone or out of place one feels, magic is all around us if you just know where to look.
Good girl. Come on, we're
gonna
take good care of you.
Let's go, gang. We're going to the bar.
What do you think, Beth? Okay, boys, there you go. Catch you guys later then. Hey guys, what's cracking? I got to quit calling this TV. This is called a video monitor. It's tore back apart again. Well, here's one of the control panel switches. Yeah. I didn't see nothing wrong with this one. This is the ones that don't control the power. So that one looked all good. So I tore the second one apart. This one's got the IR sensor and power switch all in it. Well, if this camera could justify it, see all the rust? Yeah, this thing got wet. Yeah, you can also see it on the bottom. Yeah. So what we're going to try to do is flush the switches out with some IPA. The only stuff I could get, I have, is some 91. Close enough to 100. So we're going to try to flush this out. IPA is really good at pushing water out. It's also good to clean your sores, cuts on your hands too. All I'm doing is working the contacts. Trying to get into those contacts. So I knew something was kind of off. Well, the reason why I tore it apart, it kept on going into standby. After about an hour or so, it kicks into standby. And then I noticed, when I moved it, I noticed some water coming out of the side of the casing. I was like, something ain't right. So that's when the investigation kicked in, and I tore it back apart, and I noticed there was water in his jacket, like moisture. You can somewhat still see it, too. So, that's why the TV got tore apart. I noticed something wasn't right. So, this thing just needs a little bit of wipe out. And if you didn't look through this, you can see all right. Now we should be able to Yeah, I heated up the heat gun behind you guys. You should just be able to do one thing. Don't want to get too hot. Do want to dry it out. That is some electrical contact cleaner. Would have sprayed into each one of these switches. Now we just let this crap dry. Now another thing I'm gonna do, I think I got a piece of paper down, which I do. Got some glass cleaner. I'm gonna shine up these pieces of lenses here. Try and get any type of water, moisture, away from this thing. Anything that causes the issue, I want to pull away from it. Dunn got water damage, guys, pretty bad. Unless you're going to get it for right now, let time take over. And sit out here and air dry. Okay, you're gonna have to let it air dry. But it looks better. Oh, let's check, see if there's, I still don't see no cracked joints. All right, we're good. So we'll just let this all air dry then. I'll be back in a little bit then. And go see if it's gonna work or blow. All right, boys, let's plug it in. Just like it is. Let's see. As far as I can remember, that first light standby. So let's see if it kicks in or out. Nope. It's good. Good, good, good. Let's turn on the PlayStation. You guys seeing it flicker for a second, now I got two down here. Nine dog questions you have video. Now here's the other problem I got. There is something moving on the screen. together.
Yeah, where it was somewhere.
Now you guys see it.
So we gotta check the forge, because where I thumped it, it's right here.
Thumped it like that, turned the video on. So let's shut this off.
What's that light? Works perfect now.
Kicking on every time. Okay, now we gotta figure out which board has a cracked solder. Could be this one too.
Alright, I'll be back in a little bit once I figure this which one has a cracked solder.
Alright guys, this has been like this for 20 minutes or so. Got a problem though. I tore down this, I took this modulator board apart. Can't see a cracked joint. But I do got something going on. Yeah, I had a picture. I shut the sound off. This is, I don't want copyright. Okay, see I have a picture, right? Let me grab something. There it is. Okay, got a picture, right? I got a screwdriver to thump the modulator board. Okay, maybe it's fixing itself. There it goes. See? Now I just made it go out. Where I made it go out at, right here. But I didn't see no cracked solder joints. So maybe when you guys know what's going on. So let's just wrap up this trash pick Sony Trentron. And I swear to God, when I took that apart, couldn't believe how much quality Sony put in these commercial use only products. You know, if they did what they did to the CB nowadays, I would more than glad to pay the money they're asking for these junk TVs. But the quality is not there. This thing's got a sharp image. And that's clean, clean. Even my dad said it's got a clean image. Heck, get guys up into this. You couldn't ask for a cleaner picture than that. I mean, I would die to have this back in the 90s when I was growing up. And I did fix the problem of it not restarting when I shut it off. Give it a couple minutes, give it a minute. Starts right up normal. Yep. So, there we go, guys. So, if anybody knows what's going on with that modulator, why I have to thump it, and where the crack joint would be slightly located at, be kind of helpful. The only problem is it got a slight ripple right there on the side. But that's only when the screen shrinks. I'm not going to screw with it. But other than that, this thing's pretty perfect. Alright, I'm going to catch you guys later then. I know you guys probably want to hear the sound one more time. Beautiful Sony sound. Alright, catch you guys later on.